Okay, guys, these are the words that we found to do with our investigation.
Teachers, AEIOs, Indigenous community members and students share ideas that support students developing understanding of current scientific explanations and vocabulary. Students represent their understanding using literacies of science.
Auntie Betty's come in here today to help us with our Noongar words because she helped us find all our words and to help us pronounce our words and put them in a sentence.
You've got to remember, this Aboriginal words, there's a lot of Aboriginal words because there's different parts of Australia that they've got different languages. This one usually found around here.
AEIOs and Indigenous community members provide relevant, contextualised Indigenous perspectives to enhance student participation in learning activities.
Our Noongar people lived in Maiwais. How did they build it? What did they build it with? What were some of the resources that they used to help make this Maiwai?
Palm trees.
Palm trees, yes.
Hay.
Pardon?
Hay.
Hay. We couldn't walk into a shop and say, can I have $100 worth of gum leaves, please? They had to go out and look in the bush and do their gathering. Something very important for you to remember is the Noongar people used everything that they cut down or they ate everything that they caught. So when they went hunting and gathering, nothing was thrown away or nothing was left behind. Would you like to experience staying in a maimai or sitting in a maimai during a wet, rainy day? That would be something, wouldn't it?
Water to the Aboriginal people is very important. So important that children were never allowed near where the water rolls is. A long time ago, when the earth was new, there was nothing. And the wind, all Mother Earth had was the willy willy, the wind. And then they would dance, Aboriginal people would crobbery and call out for rain to help Mother Earth.
Derbal
Yarrigan. Derbal is the Swan River, the estuary. Boya. Boya could be rocks, or boya could be money. Just any boya? Money.
So we did a great picture as well as some recording about what sort of skills you need to be a good interviewer, and I'm going to be watching for those skills in a moment. Corey, what's the first one? Can you read it from there?
Eye contact.
Well done. So when someone's talking or when you're interviewing someone, you need to make sure that you give them good eye contact, don't you? Speak clearly. That's very important, isn't it?
The Wagga went different ways, making tracks in the hilly country. Sometimes
students consider current scientific explanations to deepen their understanding and develop a literacy product to communicate this. Teachers support students to make connections between concrete, pictorial, and symbolic or abstract information. Teachers support student confidence with repetition and scaffolding. They provide visual and verbal cues and offer frequent and authentic feedback.
We went to the library to research how people use water in our community and made a class list. Some plants don't need as much water as others. It is better to water in the cooler part of the day.